Hello everybody, my name is Walter, and in this tutorial I want to show you how you can build my 5x5 double bolt door with a hidden junction, which you can see here right in front of you. As you can see, it looks like a simple 5x5 bolt door, which looks the same from each side and has on each side a pressure plate, which, if you stand on, will automatically open the door and after some time also close it again. As you can see right there. Now what's special about this door is, if you are standing inside of it when it closes, it will open up this tunnel here, which you can then use to go into your hidden base or whatever. You can also come from here, walk in there, jump up, and then simply press the button and then walk out again. So this is basically what this thing does, just a simple 5x5 double bolt door, where you have a secret entrance inside of it. By the way, if you have noticed this asymmetry here, it's not really an issue. You can simply replace this block here also with some obsidian or whatever you are using. But anyway, let's continue on with the sizes. So the entire thing here is 11 blocks wide, 9 blocks long if you count the slices with the pressure plates and the symmetry below them. And in total it's 14 blocks high. So it's actually rather high concerning the 5x5 double bolt doors I'm usually building. But this was necessary to give you enough of crawling space that you can actually walk from one side to the other when the entire thing is closed and you won't get trapped in one corner. Anyway, that's the sizes. Now let's continue on with the resources. So you're gonna need, of course, building blocks, then almost half a stack of obsidian, 20 stein blocks, 6 slabs, then for redstone components it's 46 redstone dust, 6 redstone torches, 17 repeaters, 4 comparators, 17 observers, 18 pistons, then 35 sticky pistons, a node block, although that can be replaced with a normal piston, then the 2 pressure plates, the button. And then during the building process you might actually need a lever, but this will become obvious later on in the tutorial. And I also didn't really mention those sea lanterns here. They are only there to light up the entire thing and keep mobs from spawning. They are not really necessary for the circuitry to work, and thus I haven't included them here. But anyway, that's enough of the prologue, so let's show you how to build this door here. Okay, so the first step is marking the center of the door with 3 immovable blocks, as you can see here, at the floor level. Then with a 3 wide gap towards the front and the back, we need a block with a pressure plate on top. This is where we stand on when we want to open the door. Then, when the hidden junction is going towards the right, we start on the left side here with another obsidian block down there. Then grab some observers, place 2 in this direction. Then another one going downwards here, put the block right there with a repeat on one tick there, some redstone dust on top of this observer, then a block in front of this observer and a sticky piston here, here and here, same on this side, then another observer in those gaps here, sticky pistons on top of those 3 blocks and those 3, then we need normal pistons next to those blocks there. Then on this side with the sticky piston here, first we place a block up there. Then we take an output with an observer towards front and back and run them simply into normal blocks. On this side here we need to go looking at those sticky pistons there, running into full blocks again with redstone dust on top. Then blocks in those corners with repeaters on one tick each, like so. And then in those corners here we need full blocks, and then let's build this up here with a 2x3 of normal blocks. Then we need, due to this moving slime blocks, 4 more immovable blocks. Then let's add those corners here. And then let's give it a little test run, simply power this thing here. And that's what we want to see, and also the retraction. So following that, let's connect the pressure plate to the center part here. For that, let's start with an upside down step right there, next to the sender piston there, then add 4 blocks like so, and the 5th one raised there. Grab 2 comparators, place them like so, with one running into this raised block, then put down cigarettes and dust there. Then a raised block here in front of the redstone wire, then a lowered block with a repeater on 4 ticks on top, like so. This runs into a full block, then around the corner another 2 lowered blocks with redstone dust on top. Then a raised block here with 2 torches on top and on the side here. Now this part here should extend. Now to retract the entire thing, let's simply put a lever here for the moment and turn this on. And this thing here should retract again. And now we need to simply copy this part here over to this side. And with that, the bottom part is finally done. Now let's start with the left side. For that, let's start with a block on top of this torch. Then let's actually move over this torch onto this block. Block on top and towards this side here. Torch on top of this one here and the repeater on 4 ticks on top of this one. Then we need an observer looking at it from this side here, running into a full block. Then we need a sticky piston down there and below that. Another 2 sticky pistons up here. And then another 2 normal pistons right next to that. Slime blocks to the face of those 2 sticky pistons. Then normal blocks in front of all those blocks here. Then let's go add another obsidian block here. Torch on top. Block on top. Torch to this side and on top. Then we need actually to place an upside down slab right next to this space here with some redstone wire on top. Then grab an observer facing downwards here and a repeater on top of that. And then let's quickly mirror this part here towards the back like this here. Then let's go and add another few immovable blocks here wherever the slime blocks get involved. Then let's actually fill in the rest with normal blocks. Like so. Then it's time to give a little test run. So simply turn off the lever, wait a moment, and then this should close as you can see here. And if you flick the lever again, it should also open and flatten out. So that's now working, which means now it's time to start with the top part. Now for the top part, let's start at the back with a block on top of this torch. Then we need to go with 2 blocks towards this side. Then we go up a layer and add another 6 blocks in a row, like so. Then we go down a layer and add 2 blocks going around the corner, like so. Next, put a repeater on 4 ticks here, then redstone dust on top of the blocks all the way to here. Following that, place a obsidian block here, then a lowered obsidian block there, redstone dust on top of this one here, and a repeater on 3 ticks in this direction. Then an observer looking at this repeater there, running into a full block. Then diagonal to that, we need an obsidian block with some redstone dust on top, and another raised block here. Then on the front, we need again 2 blocks, then 3 blocks raised here, 1 raised block, 1 lowered block, again redstone dust all the way over to here. Then we need an upside down slab diagonal to this block here, again with some redstone dust on top. Then place 2 obsidian blocks like so, a repeater on 4 ticks here and on 2 ticks there. Down here again an obsidian block and a lowered obsidian block, redstone dust here and a repeater on 3 ticks right there. Then grab some sticky pistons and let's start with 1 sticky piston right in front of this repeater there. Then towards left and right another sticky piston, followed by 3 slime blocks below. Then we go down here, right into the center of the door, and we go until we are essentially 1 block above the actual ceiling, which would be at this layer here. Then basically in front of those repeaters here, we need normal pistons. Then add 3 normal blocks down there. Grab some sticky pistons and place a row of 5 here, again centered, and the same on this side here. Then full blocks below those sticky pistons. Next grip some sitting blocks, place two here, one there, and that's pretty much all of the sitting blocks. Next, let's add some normal blocks to fill in those gaps. And then let's actually test out the entire thing again. So simply depower it. And now it should close up to this point and also open up and flatten out. So now the top part is also working, which means it's time for the right side. Now for the right side, let's start at the top here. First we go down a layer and place two blocks in there. Then one layer down and then again two blocks up, like so. Grab an observer, place it diagonally to this block here. Then let's place redstone dust on top of all those blocks here. Then we need a normal piston in this corner and in this corner facing inwards. Then again observers in those positions facing downwards. This time the repeaters are on two tick each, like so. Below the observers we need two normal pistons. Then next to them we need two sticky pistons with slime blocks to the face. A full block below this observer there. Then diagonal to that another full block with some redstone dust on top. Diagonal to that towards front and back a block with a repeater on one tick each going outwards. Then sticky pistons next and diagonal to the repeater there. Now let's add full blocks to all these places here. Then grab your node block, place it here, and then below the node block we need our sticky piston with a spit out block right inside of the wall here. If you don't want to use a node block here, you can also use a normal piston facing towards the front or towards the back. Would work pretty much the same way, and it would not be required to have a Minecraft version 1.13 or up. But anyway, let's go and test the entire thing once more. So let's turn off the thing here. Then it should close, as you can see here, and if we power this, it should also open and flatten out, which means now we can add another few immovable blocks here. Then fill in the rest of this wall here with normal blocks. And then we are almost finished. All that's left is more or less building the tunnel towards this side here, which you can see opening up on this point here. And this is pretty straightforward. All you have to do is first start with your walkway all the way towards the outside here. And then we simply need our two walls to each side. And that's the infrastructure done. Now we need to place a stone button on one side here. Then go towards the outside. And this is the block with the stone button. And all you need to do is add three blocks around this corner, then an obsidian step here, and connect everything with some redstone dust. And then all you have to do is simply walk in here, press the button, and it works, as you can see right there. And with that, all that's left is actually filling in the front wall and the back wall and of course in the floor. And you can actually remove this layer there. And voila! So now as you can see, I've added in the walls, in the floor, and also some light sources here to keep mobs from spawning when the entire thing is closed. But anyway, that is the end of this tutorial about this 5x5 double vault door with a hidden junction. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and well, see ya!